What is going on, everybody? Welcome to or back to Ryder's Record Collection. My name is Carl. If you fall into the back to category, you will notice that I am not in my usual setting, not in my record chair, and I'm not sitting in front of my record chair today. I am in the kitchen of my apartment, which at the moment is doubling as my record cleaning area. I've been wanting to make this video for a while. I think it's a pretty important thing that people who collect records should know or should do, and I've learned a lot from YouTube about cleaning records, and I've kind of honed my record cleaning method to what it is now because of YouTube, so I figured I'd take you through it. But first off, I want to let you know that I use the Spin Clean, and I use the Spin Clean washer fluid that it came with. I'm not totally sure what's in it, but I like it. This is the original jug that I got. I've had my Spin Clean for several years, and I use distilled water. This says purified water, but the Publix distilled water is the same thing as the purified. So without further ado, we'll change angles here and I'll show you how I clean one of my records. But actually, before we do that, here's a quick needle drop of the record that I'm going to clean. This is a Herb Albert album. Love Herb Albert, as everybody knows who watches the channel enough, but needle drop is coming at you right now. And then after I go through this whole video, we'll do a second needle drop so you guys can kind of see the difference. And as I mentioned before, you can take this with a grain of salt. It's a little anal. This is just the way that I happen to clean my records, and it works well for me. And I think it brings out some pretty quality sounds from some pretty gunky records. So hope you guys enjoy. All right, so before we get this started, here's the record. If you can tell, it is somewhat dirty. There are some hair, some dust, some fingerprints, and we're gonna see what we can't do here. This is a multi-step approach. As I mentioned, it is sort of anal, but it does a good job for me. This is the first step, and I also use the vinyl back, which we will blast over to here after we do this cleaning portion. But this is the wet portion before I dry it. So here we go. I put it in my Spin Clean. Go around three times in one direction, three times in the other direction, which is the directions on the Spin Clean. Some gunky records, I sometimes go around more, but generally three times in each direction. Let the water drip off as much as I can. What I do next, the Spin Clean directions don't recommend to do, but this is something that I picked up from somebody else's YouTube video. The video that I watched talked about how just using cleaning fluid on your records without doing the second step that I'm about to do is basically like washing your hair without rinsing out the shampoo. Made a lot of sense to me. So Spin Clean into the cleaning fluid. The second step is just a spray bottle of distilled water. And I load it up there. And this is a paint edging brush. It's got really fine micro bristles. And I just use it for water. This is my rinsing the shampoo out of the hair theory, basically. I go around once or twice with this in each direction. You saw me wipe this thing down with that first cloth, the white one. The second cloth that I use is a microfiber, and that is to dry this stuff up. And I don't get it totally dry. I go over it once real quick. I will spread this guy out here and do the shampoo rinse out, if you will, on the second side. So I have two sets of rags for coming out of the spin clean to get that soppy, soapy water up. And then I have a second set of rags for the just distilled water that's cleaning off the soppy, soapy water from the record itself. And the paint edger is what I use. I think it does a pretty good job of getting into the grooves. And then I will dry up the excess water here. And the next step is the vinyl vac, which I will bring you to right now. So here we are at the vinyl vac portion. As I mentioned, those microfibers don't necessarily get all the water off the record itself. I wouldn't go put it on the table before using the vinyl vac or before letting it air dry. I use the vinyl vac, as you can see right here, for getting any excess water up and actually sucking the water out of the grooves. I really like the vinyl vac. I'm very satisfied with this product. I really think it makes a big difference as opposed to just a wet cleaning and an air dry. And it'll get loud here for a second, but basically vinyl vac goes on, do one rotation one way, run rotation the other way. Don't spend a lot of time with the vacuum. Just two full circles in each direction and flip it over and we are done. So you will see it right now. And then I will flip it over and do the other side. And when I am done with that, it goes into the anti-static rice paper sleeve. These are basically the same as the MoFi sleeves. And I buy them from my local record store. I try to give him as much business as I can, but I will leave a link to these below. This is what he sells there. And yeah, and then my record's clean. So we'll go do a second needle trough. And we'll see how much the sound quality has improved. And we're back to our regular setting. That second needle drop, hopefully you noticed a little bit of a difference. Obviously the record's not perfect, but hopefully you could see that it played somewhat better. I think it played a lot better, but that's just my opinion. But that is how I clean my records. Take with it what you will. It is a little anal, but that's just the way that I do it. Like I said, I use the spin clean and the vinyl vac. And I've added a couple extra steps, and overall I'm very satisfied with the way that I do it. Personally, I think there's a pretty big difference between the dirty records that I buy secondhand, used at the record store after I clean them. But I'd love to know your thoughts. I'd love to know the way that some of you guys clean records. Hopefully you learned something from this video. Hopefully you picked up a thing or two that you could take away from it and incorporate into your cleaning routine. I made a video a while back on how I clean my album sleeves, so if you're interested in that, I'll leave a link down below. And hopefully you guys enjoyed this. I'll have some more content out like this soon. And we'll talk some gear, we'll talk some music, and we'll just, you know, keep on chatting about vinyl. So I'm Carl, this is Ryder's Record Collection. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please throw it a like. If you liked the channel, please consider subscribing. It would mean a lot to me, and I'd love to hear from you in the comments. I'm all about talking to people, so enjoy. Cheers, hope you liked the video. Be easy.